Greetings! Today I'm going to talk about using Ableton Live for guitar looping. This video should be pretty useful for anybody who wants to combine guitar looping with pre-produced beats that are done to a BPM or specific grid value without it all going out of time. In this video, I'm going to basically break down some of the drawbacks I think there are to actually using real loop pedals, and just some of the disadvantages and what led me to using Ableton to do it instead. So pretty much I'm just going to jump straight into this, and I have a Ditto X4 looper, and I bought specifically for this purpose of basically looping guitar up with beats to click and stuff like that. It has a MIDI connection on the back, which basically means that I can send it click track information from Ableton. So for example, if I hit spacebar, you can see that it's blinking in time with Ableton, and if I change the tempo, so yeah, you can see that it's like perfectly locked in time with Ableton, which is pretty sweet. But not every loop pedal has this, and I'm just going to talk about like what the drawback of using a loop pedal that doesn't have MIDI on it. The number one reason that I don't like using loop pedals is because most loop pedals don't have a MIDI-Sync ability, so you can't sync it up to a click track anyway. And the problem with that is that no matter how super tight you are with your looping, it's basically always going to drift out of time with any sort of like robotic click track. And I will demonstrate that here by attempting to record. So if I have this set that a bit faster. So I'm just gonna, have to do this because my loop pedal's on the desk. I'm gonna have to just like play an open chord here, and I'm just gonna try and loop this up in time without it being synced to the click, and I'll just sort of show you what happens even if I get it pretty tight. So. So you can hear that it's pretty much drifted immediately. I'll try it again and see if I can get it even maybe a little bit tighter. But you're basically fighting a losing battle if you want to try and synchronize anything with like pre-made beats. So yeah, that's pretty annoying, right? Let me show you an example of that. Hang on. So that's kind of annoying, and yeah, just doesn't really work, unfortunately. So that means you basically have to get a loop pedal, something like this, that has a MIDI in and out function on it, basically. So let's put that back in. Let's pop that into the, there we go, MIDI in. There it goes.
Greetings, I am the fix-it in postman. I forgot to mention that to do this you need an audio interface with MIDI in and out, such as the Scarlett 4i4. If your audio interface does not flipping have MIDI in and out, you will need a separate USB MIDI interface, which tend to be a bit cheaper than audio interfaces. You will also need a MIDI cable. Connect this to the MIDI out port of your audio interface to the MIDI in port of your loop pedal. Then go into Ableton's MIDI preferences and make sure your interface's MIDI out ports have track and sync enabled. You can also use the MIDI clock sync delay to adjust the click track reaching the pedal to help any latency on it. Bosh. Bob's your monk house. How's that for a slice of fried gold?
So let's try that again, but now with the pedal receiving a MIDI clock from Ableton. So let's see, it's synchronized. So I can basically use this pedal perfectly in sync with any pre pre-programmed beats, and yeah, I pretty much know that all my looping is going to be super tight. But despite that, still the reason why I gravitated away from using this pedal is just because of some of the physical problems that you can run into with units like this. So the first one that I will point out on this particular unit, obviously I got it because it has all these it's got some cool effects on it, but on my particular unit, a lot of these effects have sort of stopped working. So if I show you what I mean by that, so you've got a reverse, and that works. The halftime doesn't work, unfortunately. The once does work, so. The once just makes the loop play only once and then it stops, but yeah, the tape stop doesn't work, and most of these effects over here to the other next side have all stopped working for me, unfortunately. So the other thing that massively sketches me out about using this loop pedal for live gigs is the fact that it now has a bit of a temperamental power socket. So for example, usually you're using this sort of pedal with your foot, and it's on the ground, right? And it can sort of wobble about quite a bit, you know, if you're pressing down on your foot with it. And the trouble with that is, if I just give that a little wiggle, you'll see that the pedal has just basically just shut itself off and restarted. So if I was doing any looping, let's try and put that like to the test. Hang on a sec. So for example, so that's not great, is it? Because if that for any reason gets nudged live, and the other thing is, it's just another thing, it's a physical thing that can go wrong as part of the setup. And then, yeah, just from my experiences kind of like touring and gigging, I like to minimize the amount of equipment that I'm taking with me and kind of minimize the amount of things that I have in my setup that can basically go wrong. And obviously physical devices all kind of are subject to wear and tear from age, especially things like loop pedals or foot, you know, guitar foot pedals that are just getting kicked constantly or whatever. So yeah, basically I think that there is a better way, and I shall show you that now. By the way, I'm using Archetype Corey Wong for my guitar tone. It's just like one of my basic clean tones. So and yeah, I basically think that just you don't really need a physical loop pedal if you've got a copy of Ableton, and it will be more reliable and tight. So this is the looper device, and it lives under audio effects, delay and loop, and yeah, I'll just sort of show you what it can do. So it also has a reverse button on it. I've got that effect that's on this Ditto X4, but here in looper, and I can emulate some of what these other effects in here are doing with some of the built-in Ableton effects. But just to kind of show you the basic thing of how this works, for example, if I set the quantization to 1 bar, and yeah, and then I can basically tell it, I can also tell it how many bars I want it to record for before the loop begins, and I can also determine the behavior of what the loop does. And then yeah, if you had a foot controller, you could assign all these controls, you know, to controls on the foot controller. I personally have a Korg Nano control, and for example, I can assign things like the stop and start buttons to different buttons on my Korg Nano control. And for example, I could say like this R here is the reverse. So for example, so that gives me some control of the looper that way. But the thing that I love about using this in Ableton is actually not really having to do any sort of manual control of the looper at all, but using instead automation to tell it when I want it to do things. Let's go into the timeline view here. I'm going to tell my looper exactly when I want it to do certain things. So you need to enable automation mode, and then here you can control the looper. So if you select the state control here, let's say I want my drums to sort of start here, right? And I don't want the looper to be doing anything until the drums start. and then for the first loop of the drums. So yeah, I want the guitar to record throughout this passage here, and then I want it to play. On the second drums loop, I want the looper to stop playing. So I'm finding that pretty useful because it can basically, yeah, I can control the looper without actually having to touch anything. And I just find that really, really useful for, yeah, just focusing on purely my playing and not having to worry about turning things on and off at specific points. And you can obviously control like the overdubbing. So for example, if I want to add like a second layer to that, maybe here we can go into overdub mode and then have that just play. So I'm going to see if I can come up with something here. Might sound terrible, but... So I think that's pretty cool. Just that's more control than I would get over this loop pedal from doing it with my feet. And it's just kind of like, if your performance is like, if you're not really like improvising and you're playing to specific song structures and you know exactly where all the choruses and the verse changes are, and you know when things are meant to start and stop, then I think it's just such an easy and kind of freeing way to do it. Because as you can see, I just have to like, I can purely just focus on playing the guitar and not really worrying about, you know, having this other stuff in the back of my mind that I've got to get right, you know? Which I think is really, really nice, and it kind of gives you a bit more ability to do other fun things, maybe like playing keys and then going back to guitar looping without, you know, having to worry about so much physical logistics, basically. The other advantage of doing things in Ableton to a specific BPM grid like this is that any time-based effects like delays and stuff like beat repeat, which I really, really like, will all be perfectly in sync with the grid and the drums, right? So if I show you what that'd be like. I'm gonna create a loop and then just have it play here for quite a while, so I can put some different effects on it. But so if I turn up a little bit of delay on that guitar, you can hear that the delays are like bang in, which is like pretty cool, because again, that's another thing. If I was trying to do that with like an actual like a delay pedal, for example, like a DL4 or a Strymon timeline, you can set obviously exact BPM values, but even if it's separate to this system and you're just playing it through the pedal, there's still a chance that these things kind of drift out of each other. So just the fact that the guitar is going through Ableton and it's all part of this software system, and there's only one MIDI clock that anything cares about, if that makes sense. So it just means that everything's going to be super tight. And yeah, if I just do some more, I want to do something else. So let's go again. And let's get out. So things are starting to go a bit mad. Just to quickly go over a little beat repeat here. I can use this to, so what I like to do is I assign beat repeat. I assign the repeat on off button to a button on my nano control. And then I assign the grid knob to a knob here on it. And then if I turn the chance all the way down so that it doesn't automatically turn itself on, and then basically I can do like IDM style glitches on this guitar part whenever I fancy. So. Thank you. And the other advantage I'd like to point out about this over some like other pedals that can do that kind of delay, beat, repeat, hold effect or whatever you call it, like this has that hold effect. And you can kind of like, when this worked, I used to be able to do similar stutters, right? But with this, it's like, you can see, I can be super specific about the grid value. And that means that I can kind of create glitchy phrasings out of the parts that I've recorded, which I think is pretty sick. So if I wanted to do like a triplet stutter over those beats. And yeah, I can assign the pitch decay, for example, to another knob here, and then... So, yeah, I think that's kind of something really, really powerful about using your guitar in Ableton and in the setup like this, basically. So, yeah. Just to give a quick contextual example of this actually in like a performance setting, I've switched over to my project file for my Cactuar Collective / Final Fantasy VII live set. I'm just going to show you an example of the song called In Search of the Man in Black. And basically in this track, in my live performance of it, I'm basically switching between playing the guitar and playing the synths, and I'm using the Ableton loop device to basically enable me to do that. So I'm going to play a little example of what I would do here. I'm unfortunately not playing the, don't have my keyboard set up, but I'll just sort of, maybe I'll air mime it where I'm meant to be playing keys, and then I'll show you how the looper works, which enables me to kind of switch between the two instruments live, basically. So if I get out the guitar track here, and if I look at the looper automation, yeah, you can see I've got it to record here, play, and then an overdub track happens, and then I'm just going to show you like what I can basically do with that. So here goes. So I hope that provides some insight into why I kind of prefer using Ableton Live as a looper and some of the advantages that you can get from doing it this way versus using a physical pedal. Thanks very much for watching, and yeah, take it easy.